The last we have discussed about the classification of advertising that is based on consumers, based on media, based on businesses, on the basis of area, on the basis of advertising stages, and on the basis of functions. Today, we are going to discuss on the basis of functions, or we can say functional classification. Advertising is also classified according to their functions and role. Some of the important classifications of advertising are, the number one is social advertising. When you actually seek the companies who are actually work as NGOs, trust, society, association, when you undertaken their work, so it is basically the undertaken by non-commercial companies such as trust, societies, association. The main objective of these advertising is to work for social cause. Advertisements for collecting donations for war victims or for victims of natural calamities, sales of tickets for a show are example of social advertising. Basically, NGOs are involved in these trust societies, which are actually there for the person who has faced some problem regarding some natural calamities, whether it is war or any earthquake or tsunami, anything. When they are actually offering something for them, when they create advertisement on the basis of these problems, they are conducting the social advertising. The next one is political advertising. Political advertising is undertaken by political parties to motivate the general public in favor of the ideology of the party in question. Political advertising are intensively made during such times to gain favor of the voters. See, nowadays even अच्छे दिन आ गए हैं, the advertising for the promotion of BJP is very much seen by us, because the political party basically want to attract the attention of the voters so that they will have more votes. So it is basically when the advertising are taken by the political parties to have more number of votes so that they have favor from their voters, so they create such type of advertisements. Advertising promote plans and policies of the concerned party. It is also try to expose weakness of opposition with the view to convince the voters to vote for their party candidates. You must have seen these ads in which they actually brought up their features and the weaknesses of the opposite parties. Some political advertisements are also made to assist the government to implement in schemes for rehabilitation and natural reconstructions. Mumbai Regional Congress Committee, children affected by communal riots in Mumbai under the scheme of National Foundation for Communal Harmony. This committee actually promote the ad regarding, because they are actually promoting the children. They are actually helping the children who are affected by the communal riots in the Mumbai. Advertisements issued by a political party is essentially a political advertisement. So when these parties conduct the any advertisement, when they create any advertisement to have more votes, they are actually conducting the political advertising. Advocacy advertising is basically when they have actually advertisement which are related to use of family planning methods, conservation of scarce resources, maintaining green environment in today's scenario, especially to promote the goals of sustainable development. There are many number of advertisements who are focused on green environment, stay safe, green environments. Companies can place advocacy advertising on billboards, in print magazines, newspaper, online, and on television also. Advertising by Google. In today's scenario, we focus, Google actually plays a number of ads whenever you are actually trying to see something, some ad pop up. Like, for example, Pond's Age Miracle Cream. Looking young is now really easy. Gets Pond Prevention Tricks. They have mentioned their site. This is the sort of explanation Google provided for a company. Use Olay Total Effects. Tips for beautiful skin. Come to Kaya Clinic, gym management course, admission open for MSW. All these ads somehow pop up on Google when you are actually browsing some particular thing. So this is also one of the functional advertisement. Retail advertising. Retail advertising is the advertising by retailers who usually sell goods direct to the consumer. They are the middleman from the manufacturer to the consumers. So they sell their goods to the consumers. Retail advertising has objectives. Number one, to sell the stock. They want to sell all their stock which is available to them. Second, to establish the identity of business. They want to create a brand image of their business. Third, to track personal telephonic or mail order shoppers. Or they want to track some personal, the retailer, the consumers which can come to their shop for any telephonic order or any mail order. Retail advertising is done through window display, neon signs, posters or leaflets, etc. It is usually local in character. Financial advertisement. When an advertising message is directed to attract for raising capital, it is called financial advertising. Banks, insurance companies, commercial undertakings collect required from funds from the saving of the people by motivating them to postpone present expenditure to future period. For this, I want to quote example here, mutual fund advertisement. You have come across with number of mutual fund advertisement, and that is part of this advertisement only. An investor considered two things before investing his hard-earned money. Safety of investment, return on investment. Whenever a person wants to invest in your company, he wants that his investment would be safe and there will be more return on the investment. The safety of investment depends upon the reputation and goodwill of the company. For example, if I will want to invest in a company called Reliance Company. It has more reputation, it has brand, it has a great goodwill. And there is a company which name is ABC Limited. I will not prefer to invest my funds in particular company because that is not established one. It is not a reputed company. So I want to prefer the company which is already established, which has a good rapport, which has good goodwill. The institutional advertising helps in creating confidence in the minds of investors. These sort of advertisements somehow create confidence in the minds of the person who wants to invest. The financial advertisement informs the investors about the past performance in declaring dividends and the trend in declaring of dividend. These sort of advertisement actually shows the growth rate of the company by showing their dividend, which they have paid in past, and also by indicating the dividend they will pay in the future. The dividend depends upon the profitability of the company. So they somehow wants to tell you the profitable position of the company by showing you dividend policy of the company. The company, with the help of chart diagrams, communicate the rate of growth and the rate of which profit is increasing. The company can also, this sort of advertisement can also consist of any chart, any diagram which actually shows the growth rate and the profit rate of the company. The financial advertising aims at establishing financial solvency of the company in the minds of prospective investors. Obviously, if your company is showing a profit rate, you will see the solvency position of company will be very good. It is because of financial advertising the company have succeeded in floating off mega issue of shares that is must be in crores. The financial advertising aims at establishing financial solvency of the company in the minds of prospective investors. It is because of financial export. So this sort of advertisement basically create an idea of good, better company with a good reputation, who has some prospects for the future, who can pay the dividend, who can actually have good profit position, have good solvency position. So this consists of financial advertising. The next is corporate image advertising. This particular advertising is designed or aimed to create a proper attitude towards the seller and to build goodwill or image of the advertiser. This particular advertising type basically consists of where it wants to create a good image of the company on the consumers, and they want to attract more sales volume rather than to sell a specific product or services. So corporate image basically emphasis on the more sales volume with customer satisfaction as well as building good image of the company. Institutional advertising is done to build good public relation image in the market for the marketer and a patronage for its product or its product or products. Institutional advertising can therefore be advertising and a public relation service advertising. So basically what institutional advertising is, basically he wants to create a good public relation with the customer. The company wants to create an image that has a good relation with the consumer. So public relation institutional advertising is aimed to create a favorable image of a company among employees, investors or general public. Public service institutional advertising aim at changing the attitudes or behavior of the people to the good of the community or public at large. These sort of advertisements somehow create an image in the create the image in the minds of people that the company is good. It actually affect public at large in number. Patronage advertising is aimed to attract customers by appealing to their patronage buying motives rather than product buying motives. This basically focus on their continuous pattern of the buying motives instead of one time buying motives. Most of the companies are successful in making their image in the minds of people by using their names such as Bata, Tata, Bombay Dyeing. These have very good image among the minds of consumers. All these companies have created a very good image. They have created, they have actually affected public at large, so that it is some sort of corporate advertising. Public relation advertising, it is a part of institutional advertising. The basic objective of company public relation advertising is to establish cordial and healthy relation with the consumers, bankers, suppliers and governments, patrons and the general public. This is basically a part of the institutional advertisement. This particular type impact on very nice and healthy relationship with bankers, suppliers, government, customers, patrons, and general public and the company itself. Through public relation advertising, company announce the changes in its policy, its developmental activity, its position and stand when the employees are on strike. It helps the company to remove any misconceptions about the company created by interested group. This sort of advertisement basically wants to promote the good image of the company. If any sort of misconception have created by any competitive party, so company with the help of this particular advertising can remove that misconception. During the periods of short supply of goods, the public relation advertising helps to hold the interest of the customers. The company assures about the normalcy of supply and requests its customer to bear with the company. If a company faces any sort of problem, they can also convey to the general public so that they can request their customers to bear with the company. Institutional advertising and public relation advertising are complementary to each other. These both are complementary to each other. They have one direction, basically to build up the corporate image. There are several reasons as to why a corporate firm may resort to public relation advertising. The reasons are to create a favorable image of organization. If a company want to create a good image, to secure and keep their good suppliers, to build goodwill of the dealers, to arouse and serve customers in a better way, to create attention of the present and potential shareholders, to correct misconception about the firm during strikes, to win confidence of its employers, to render community service, to make people aware of social evils and health hazards, to obtain public support for certain causes. these are the reason why a company want to create a positive image. If a company want to have a good and cordial relation, these are the points which they have to convey to the customers by large number. Institutional advertising is basic main objective of institutional advertising is to build the manufacturer's reputation in the minds of public in general. The advertising message is directed to tell the to tell about the company, its people, its contribution in promoting social welfare activities, in promoting customer satisfaction and its achievements in technology, the broader philosophies, the economic progress of a company. This particular company basically convey you about the company's prospects, company's people, company's contribution toward any social activity, customer satisfaction, any achievement in technology, the broad philosophy the company has adopted, and the economic progress of the company. Such advertisement do not bring benefits in the form of higher sales immediately, but they create good footing for the company in the long run. The competitive strength of the company goes up by enhancement of corporate image. Basically, this is a very lengthy process, but company usually adopt this because they want to create a long-term effect on the customers. It is much easier for a highly reputed company to launch a new product in the market. If a company is very reputed, it is much, much easier for that company to launch a new product. Basically, the institutional advertising aims at getting public support for raising the capital through public subscription. This sort of advertisement very helpful for the companies if they want to raise any capital. For example, if a Tata company want to go for the public subscription to raise the capital, it will be very easier for them instead of buying any ABC company. The following points are referred to institutional ad. Number first is research and development of the firm, number of factories or branches of the firm, number of employees and facilities available to them, foreign collaboration, distribution network of the firm, market position of the firm, product or services offered by the firm, social welfare programs undertaken by the firm. Basically, these ad consist on these pointers. These ad consist of the employees they have, the facilities they provide to them, if any foreign collaboration, their number of factories, branches, the product services which they offer, any sort of good social welfare programs they are doing for a company. So these ads consist of these highlighter of the companies. The next is internet advertising. Internet facility has been around for some 30 years now. It is actually begin in 1960 in USA, where the US Department of Defense saw it as a means of supercomputer communication for researcher and military facilities across the country. From the last 30 years, this is very much in use. But in 1960 in USA, US Department firstly used these ads to US Department of Defense to communicate about the military facilities across the country. Until its commercial explosion in 1990s, the internet remained a relatively obscure network of linked computers, mostly by academics, military researchers, scientists around the world to send and receive electronic mail, transfer file, and find or retrieve information about databases. Before 90, it was used to send emails, to transfer file, to retrieve an information. But from 1990s, the internet advertising commenced. At present, internet, the fastest growing medium in history, offers incredible opportunities for a wide range of people in both business and advertising. For advertisers, there is a whole new world of potential customers. Primary demand advertising. The main objective of primary demand advertising is to create demand for a new product or product category. When a company wants to create a demand for new product, they actually go for primary demand advertising. This is necessary in a case of newly developed products or the products which are costly in the nature. For example, cars, refrigerators, washing machine, watches. Such advertising is directed towards a class of customers. It is also described as selective demand advertising. It is heavily utilized during the introduction stage of a productive life cycle. This basically when they want to introduce any new type of product in the market. Primary demand is when a potential buyer or prospect is showing interest in a product or a service for the first time. Oftentimes, it is because the prospect was never exposed to the concept of the product or service or never really understood it. But now, due to new circumstances, it is apparent all of a sudden. Selective demand advertising is basically done to meet the growing competition, mainly in growth stage of life cycle of a product. When a product at its height, at the growth stage of its life, then they actually use selective demand advertising. The main goal of this advertisement is to push the demand of specific product or services. Promotion becomes less informative and more emotional during this phase. This sort of advertising may begin to stress subtle differences in brand with emphasis on brand name recall. When they want to recall their consumer, when they want to remind their consumer particular about a company, about a product, they often go for selective demand advertising. At this stage, pricing may also be used as a weapon because product of all the competitors are almost similar in the quality. Product advertising. It is refers to advertising for the tangible product. It is for the market of the product advertising as a powerful instrument has emerged. A product may be anything in which a trader deals or trade. This product may be tangible or intangible. Products like radio, soap, pen, clothes are tangible products, and services offered by professional people like doctors, lawyers, engineers are intangible products. So when any sort of advertisement related to these products or services are offered by the companies, this is called product advertisement. The fundamental of any advertising campaign is to establish the fact that among the substitutes, the product advertised is the best. Thus, product is the heart of advertising program. So they want to create a build image of the company by featuring the product or services of the company. Advertisement make possible for the smooth entry of new product in the market. Service advertisement is designed to operate in the public interest. It is undertaken to seek the public welfare and social development policy. It is in the nature of non-commercial institutional advertising. In this type of advertising, the objective is to put across a message intending to change attitude or behavior of the customers. As a result, benefit the public at large. This sort of advertising is basically when they want to convey a message to public at large. Then they opt this sort of advertisement. It is non-commercial in nature and it is for the public welfare. For example, nowadays they have actually given you ad regarding COVID-19. You actually come across with these type of ads numerous times. It is generally used by government and other organizations to promote public welfare. See, even when you call a person, there is a mic who starts speaking due to COVID-19. You have to see, you have to take some precautions. So these are the basically type of service advertising. Many companies have also taken up public causes such as supporting a leprosy eradication program, avoiding pollution, safe driving, blood donation, by resorting to public service advertising only. National advertising. It is generally undertaken by manufacturers of branded goods for which advertising messages communicated to consumers all over the country. Basically, these advertisements are taken by manufacturers of very well-established and branded goods. they want to communicate about their products all over the countries at customer large, almost all possible mass media, including national newspaper, radio, television, network are employed for national advertising, product, services, and ideas which have demand all over the country are suitable for national advertising. In India, Indian Airline, Hindustan Lever Limited, Vico, Godrej, Bajaj are a few leading advertisers at a national level. Likewise, detergent, soaps, toothpaste, cosmetics, scooters, cars, bicycle are some of the products which are advertised all over the country. When the companies opt for these advertisements, they want to capture the consumer at large. Till here, we have finished with the topic advertisement. Next, we are going to start with the topic trends in advertising. The classification has been finished. Now we will start the topic in new trends in advertising. See, with the explosion in the social media, with the more exposure of internet, instant messaging, many platforms, especially on internet-enabled smartphones, some of trends and formats likely to prevail and gain their structure in 2021, which include conversion marketing, highly individualized one-to-one advertising, influencer marketing, mobile advertising within app and in games ad, video advertising, video embedded display banners, native advertising, accelerated pivot to automation, programmatic advertising, and even a cookie-less advertising, among others. Many new types of advertisement have been seen in nowadays during the year 2021. If you see, in today's world, internet has a very large platform. Internet is usage for the last sort of platform. So any ad, whether it is mobile advertising, whether it is one-to-one, whether it is any native advertisement, all these will become a new trends in advertisement. First one is conversational marketing. This facilitates one-to-one real-time connection between consumers and the marketers. According to a research, when a customer asks a question, 82% want an immediate response. This basically ensures from the customer point of view, whenever a customer have a question, you are going to answer immediately. See, sometimes you may come across with the sort of pop-up window where they ask you, do you wanna, some pop-up message appear asking, how may I help you? Sometimes if you see any, if you open any sort of educational site, they will ask you, how we are going to help you? This is basically under this type of marketing. As such, conversational marketing would continue to be an important part of successful marketing strategy, whereby business can gain the lasting trust and loyalties of customers. The new age, all technology-enabled chat boxes are at the forefront of conversational marketing. Highly personalized content experience. Another trend that is likely to prevail in 2021 would be branded delivery, highly individualized ad content experiences for end customers. This is for basically us. This is for end user customer. Unlike generic ads meant for collective audience, they would use the latest technology to know what an individual customer wants, how they are going to serve the customers. They actually create an ad accordingly. Sending personalized video messages would become more common now. Also, the navigation experience for consumers would be more user-friendly with more sophisticated and clutter-free landing page design, effective call-to-action tools, as well as clear and catchy headlines and legs. Sometimes you create a very catchy headlines so that whenever a customer is online, they want to press, they want to see what this particular company ad consists of. Experiential marketing is enabling a more direct and interactive form of communication between a brand and its audience, they would witness more action, especially on digital platform in the year 2021. It is not merely about trade shows and conference. See, whenever you have to see ad regarding any trade show, regarding any conference, regarding any fair, these all part of this sort of marketing. But it involves creating a process, memorable interaction between brands and the customer, both existing and potential. In today's case, if a customer wants to have a talk with the company, he usually go for this sort of marketing. The objective is to help the customer build positive association with the brand. Mobile advertising with ever-rising smartphone penetration and end users spending more and more time on their phones for e-commerce and entertainment, including usage of videos and OTT platform, mobile advertising will possibly become one of the biggest trend in 2021. With the usage of more smartphones, mobile advertising is very common now. It has become very biggest platform. Along with the search and the mobile browsers, while in app ads and in games, ad would see heightened action. The rising story ads on social media platforms such as Instagram and other would fuel this medium. Programmatic advertisement is basically consists of traditional RFPs. Instead of using RFPs, insert orders and negotiation, all driven platform would enable media purchase in a real-time bidding context with an eye on niche audience. Over the year, it has emerged as a key digital marketing tool across industry. An earlier estimation had predicted that about $81 billion would be spent programmatically by 2021. Video advertisement. In the year 2021, to see the intrinsic appeal of the format, short form videos and presentations, this sort of advertising is creating that is known as video advertising. In fact, videos would be embedded into display banners, enhancing the attractiveness quotient for the brand while communicating a message more meaningfully to the desired audience. These sort of ads, you must see whenever you see a YouTube ad, then there appears a video messages, video sort of advertisement. You see mutual fund ads, especially insurance companies ad, they want to target some audience, they want to create meaningful ad to them, they want to catch their attention. The live streaming of videos would also enable the delivery of more timely. Obviously, it is very precise, it is very timely ad, and the context relevant ad content to the end customers. Because of these sort of ad, this is very easy for the companies to convey their messages. Native advertising is basically, it has been used from the last few years now, allowing ad content to subtly and seamlessly blend into larger environment without intruding into viewers' experiences. It will remain an important tool in the hand of marketer and advertiser in 2021 too. These sort of ads, when they don't want to interrupt the large environment, but somehow they will become part of the advertisement agencies. Influencer marketing, another big trend likely to catch on its marketing and advertising industry would be influencer marketing in 2021. You have seen a number of bloggers on YouTube. They want to create this type of ad. They are actually influencer marketers. With the traditionally celebrity endorsement route increasing, losing their luster, and the always on interactive nature of social media platforms, brands would opt for influencers. These influencers actually catch big attention of the customers. They have more number of followers for them. So the companies want to opt for the influencers who typically come with recognition and credibility in the niche subjects. Their dedicated following would not only better amplify a brand products and services, but also cut down on costs for the brand. Sharp pivot to automation. With stressed budgets due to COVID, marketers and advertisers would stick with the automation route even when budgets get to normal level, with an eye on keeping costs low and improving overall efficiency in 2021. Very crisp ad given by the company. Due to their less budget, they opt for this type of advertisement. Thank you.